The next point we're going to discuss in JVA Perimeter Patrol is the actual setup of your emails and alarms. So I'm going to go up to Setup, click on Setup, click on System Configuration, go to the tab that says Alarms and Emails. The function of this specific tab is to set up that you can get either once-off emails when there's a immediate alarm activation, like what this first point suggests. You can get or set it to email you when an alarm is resolved. So when someone has actually cleared the alarm, entered it in the log and closed the alarm off. Another very nice function is the email unresolved alarm list daily at a specific time. This could be unresolved alarms of the previous night that hasn't been attended to, or might still be a fault on the fence where installer needs to come out and actually look at that problem. This will then be emailed to the actual supervisor or to whichever addresses is selected, and that person will get this daily report every morning at a specific time. The specific system configuration for alarms and emails is set up so it can use your settings from your ISP. One would have to contact your ISP to find out what your SMTP server settings would be, what port it would use, also the from address, and the to address would basically be multiple addresses separated by a comma. And that would go to your control room manager, your supervisor, or perhaps a external third-party company that is monitoring your perimeter patrol system from a different location. Your email priority can be set to either low, normal, or high, and your outgoing mail server can be set if it requires authentication. Once again, this is something that you would have to discuss with your specific ISP, the person hosting the specific domain of email addresses that you would like to use. They will be able to supply you with the necessary settings regarding your incoming and outgoing email. They would also be able to tell you if your outgoing mail server requires encrypted connection, SSL, which one could also click on or click off at this point over there. It does say here, limit emails to 10 emails per hour. That setting can be changed to more emails or less emails. The specific reason for this is if you've got an alarm going off because of a branch that has basically fell on your fence and you've got two wires shorting out, and you are waiting for a company to come out, you've reported it to your supervisor, and unfortunately that company is in a call out, but they can't attend to the situation in the next hour. You don't want a specific user to get 20, 30, even 50 emails in that 1 hour. So it can be limited to 10 emails per hour. Up here, there's also a alarm delay setting, which means that if your fence is shorting out, let's say again the same example, a branch has fallen onto your fence and it's shorting out your wires, you can set an alarm delay in seconds, and you can also set an alarm reset delay in amount of seconds. I'm just gonna save and close because we have completed the system configuration at this point, and we will be moving on to a live demo at one of our sites.